Hey everybody, it's Trevor here with the channel where every day is range day. In this week's video, we're going to be going through my full review of the Holosun 508T version 2 red dot sight. Let's check it out. Alright everybody, if you've been following the channel for the last year or so, you probably know that I've been using the Holosun 508T version 2 red dot sight as my EDC optic on my carry gun, which is the Glock 19 here, which is, of course, clear. I've had the 508T version 2, which is now the X2 if you were to buy it today, for just over a year now. I think I got it in early October last year in 2020. After ordering it way back in March, and it's now early December in 2021, which puts me just at around 14 months or so with this particular optic as my EDC option. And as such, I figured it'd be a good time to go through my full review of this optic from Holosun, which will include a general update on the condition of the optic and my overall experiences with its longevity and performance over the past 14 months or so. Back in October last year when I first got this optic and had it for about 2 weeks or so, I did a first impressions video where I talked about the main features of the optic and sort of compared it to the Trigicon RMR and just gave my initial impressions on it as well. So definitely check it out if you want to know more details about all the different features that this optic has to offer. I won't be going into too much depth about it here. But in a nutshell, the 508T version 2 is the elite version of Holosun's pistol optics. It comes in the box that you can see here with the pick rail, and essentially it's an open emitter reflex style red dot sight with Holosun's multiple reticle options, their signature solar panel, and a host of their other features that are pretty standard on most of their optics. What classifies the 508T as their elite optic over their 507C flagship model is the titanium housing that you will note in its construction. Of course, you can see that it is squared up around the edges for a little bit more durability, and of course the titanium is what gives it the T in 508T. But moving into my full review, the 508T has sat on my EDC Glock 19 concealed carry firearm for the past 14 months, and it's been the only one I've used on this handgun. It's been with it everywhere I take it, and I've shot it a ton on the range, indoors, outdoors, carried it with me everywhere I go when I'm allowed to. So I've got plenty of experience with this optic in a variety of different conditions, and this review will be made primarily from an EDC standpoint for this optic. Overall, my impressions and experiences with the Holosun 508T have been very, very positive. I've enjoyed having the optic as my EDC option for the past 14 months, and I would definitely recommend it overall. But getting more into the review, we're going to take a look at just two main areas, one being just the overall durability and longevity of the optic, basically how it's held up over the year. Does it still work? How's the battery life? Is the fit and finish held up still? More of the physical longevity of this particular unit. Then I'm also going to talk a little bit about the performance of the optic from a shooting perspective. So starting off first with the overall longevity and durability of the optic, from a physical standpoint, it has performed exceedingly well. There's no marked defects on the fit and finish that haven't been imposed by me myself. The optic itself and all of its features and functionalities perform exactly as they did straight out of the box. No complaints there. The housing itself, again, is made out of titanium. There's no dents or dings on it at all. The coating on the housing itself has held up very, very well, and the rubber material on both of the buttons and in the battery compartment has held up as well. No problems with water getting in the emitter, no leaks or anything like that. The glass itself is still in very, very good condition. There's no issues or scratches with it. Again, I haven't been chucking this thing down the hills and into the mountains or anything like that. There's no scratches or chips or otherwise damage to the lens. None of the coatings have been peeling or flaky. The seal between the lens and the housing has remained intact, and there are no discernible issues with the glass whatsoever. The only thing that I would mention about the 508T, particularly with the glass and the seal on the inside of the housing, is that there does appear to be a little channel where dust or fuzz tends to like to collect. And I have noticed that after leaving it on the nightstand overnight for a couple weeks at a time, that there does tend to be a lot of buildup in there. Again, I have two cats and a dog, so that likely contributes to the situation, and it does need cleaning out. It doesn't really affect the functionality of the optic at all, but when you go to present, sometimes you can see all that buildup on the edges, and it can be a little bit distracting. The same can be said for the small portion of glass in front of the emitter. It has not become scratched or damaged otherwise, and as a result, the reticle itself has remained clear and sharp as it had straight out of the box. This also is a testament to the durability of the LED and the quality of the electronics in the optic. They have held up just as well as the physical casing on the optic itself. Again, the reticle remains clear and crisp inside the glass. All of the reticle options, brightness settings, solar panel functionality, all of that works just as it should straight out of the box. And on the topic of the reticle and electronics itself, I have not changed the battery in the Holosun 508T since I put the initial one that you get from Holosun in the optic to start. Holosun claims around 50,000 hours of battery life with sort of intermediate settings on the optic, which I've sort of had it on, and 50,000 hours equates to roughly 5 or 6 years or so. Having had this optic for around 14 months now, this puts me right at or around the 10,000 hour mark on the original battery. It's typically advised to change your optic batteries once a year just so you're safe, but I wanted to let this run a little longer just to see how much I could get out of it. And after about 10,000 hours or so, compared to Holosun's advertised 50,000 hours, the 508T has shown no signs of dimming a reticle, no flickering or anything like that. The battery seems to still be going strong, and again, this partially relies upon the solar panel on the top of the optic to supplement the battery life. It's contingent upon my own use with the brightness settings and the circle dot reticle that I primarily run at my own brightness levels, but it's also greatly enhanced by the shake awake feature, which is one of my favorites among the Holosun offerings. If I set this firearm here and don't touch the optic for about 10 or 15 minutes or so, it will shut off and go into sort of a sleep mode. Then the moment I pick the firearm up, it'll flick back on into the settings that it was last set at, and I'll be good to go. This greatly helps extend the battery life with LEDs, which are efficient altogether, and I'm happy to say that this feature also continues to work flawlessly. I know battery life can be a big concern for some people, and it is definitely not a concern or issue for the Holosun 508T version 2. And that about sums it up for the durability and the longevity of this optic from an EDC standpoint. Again, I'm not rolling around in the woods and throwing this thing down mountains or anything, but for the average civilian who carries every single day, this is a top-notch choice and you shouldn't have any issues with it holding up from a physical durability standpoint. The housing is in remarkable condition, all the functionality works flawlessly after a year, there's no problems with the glass or any of the coatings on the lens, and of course the emitter and the electronics have held up phenomenally. And I've been very, very pleased with the Holosun 508T in this EDC capacity, especially from a durability standpoint. Just can't go wrong with it. Moving on from general longevity and durability of the 508T, in this full review, we'll now talk about its performance as an actual red dot sight to be used on a handgun or other maybe pistol caliber carbine. The 508T did come with a pick mount, so you could put it on a rifle or a pistol caliber carbine if you would so choose, but I've only ever used it on a pistol. Additionally, in the original video where I gave my first impressions of the 508T, I also talked about how it compared, at least from a visual and, you know, first glance perspective, with the Trigicon RMR, which is sort of the flagship standard in the industry for micro red dot sights that go on handguns. Some of the key differences that I noted there were, one, of course, the multiple reticle options, being the dot, a circle dot, or just the circle, as well as a slightly larger viewing window and much clearer glass that doesn't have quite as much of the blue tint as that particular RMR that I had does. Both of those I take to be slight advantages for the Holosun 508T over the RMR. You just get a bit more flexibility in what kind of reticle you like. The viewing window has been incredibly generous, and the glass has had no issues with glare being clear in general, and again, durability, as I've mentioned previously. The multiple reticle options are also just another benefit. Other optics on the market, including the RMR, sometimes just only have a dot, which is of course fully achievable with the 508T. But you can also opt for Holosun's signature circle dot reticle, which has your little 2 MOA dot in the middle and then a 32 MOA ring around it. It's a little funny to get used to, especially compared to just a little 2 MOA dot. There's a lot more light projected onto the lens of your optic, but it catches your eye a whole lot quicker when you're going to ready your gun up, and I definitely prefer that over having just a tiny little dot. And this is particularly advantageous in an EDC environment. Most encounters that you would run into from an EDC perspective where you'd have to draw your gun for defensive purposes typically happen within 25 feet of you, and the majority of those are even closer, say 9 or 10 feet. At those closer distances, the precision of a 2 MOA dot is just not needed, and it's a lot better to have a quicker acquisition of a slightly larger reticle, being the ring. And I can only agree with the sentiment that the circle dot reticle performs exceedingly well in closer quarter situations. But the multiple reticle system does give you the flexibility to put just a little 2 MOA dot on there if the precision is really what you're after, or if that's just what you prefer. And going more into shooting itself, the 508T has managed the recoil of a 9mm just fine, as it should. And I should also note that all my experiences relate to this particular handgun, the Glock 19 9mm. But with the Glock 19 9mm, I've shot many, many rounds through it with this optic sitting on top. I've had no issues with it damaging the optic, doesn't move it around or cause it to lose zero, and doesn't damage the electronics or anything like that. This is definitely an important characteristic to consider in some of the cheaper optics that might be damaged by repeated recoil or even lose zero over the course of a long period of time where you keep shooting and shooting and shooting. The 508T has suffered zero issues from recoil and has remained zero throughout its life. I zeroed it as soon as I got it, and I check zero every couple months just out of habit. And I'm pleased to report that the 508T has never deviated from its original zero. I zero it for around 25 yards and it has stayed there the whole time. Overall, the 508T has been a joy to have on this handgun, and I definitely enjoy shooting with it. And I would definitely recommend the 508T as a red dot sight from a performance standpoint. Well, that looks like it's going to be it for the video this week, guys, on my full review of the Holosun 508T pistol red dot sight. The 508T version 2 has been my EDC carry gun optic for the past 14 months, and I have definitely enjoyed it to say the least. I haven't had any issues with the optic holding up in terms of durability throughout the year. It works just as it should, and the battery life has definitely been impressive to boot. I'm running at about 10,000 hours now, and it's still going strong. And this speaks wonders to the build quality of the optic itself, and also the quality of the electronics that reside within it. From a performance standpoint, it has a very, very generous viewing window. The multiple reticle options are incredibly helpful in an EDC situation. I am a huge fan of the circle dot reticle myself, and it's what I've used the whole time. If you like this video, feel free to leave a like down below. If you have any questions about the 508T or want to share your experiences with other Holosun options, feel free to leave them down below in the comments. We'd love to hear from you. And as always, make sure to subscribe to the channel, where every day is range day. Thank you for watching.